Good morning. My name is Angela Evans, and I'd like to welcome you this morning to the Sterling First United Methodist Church. Whether you are joining us in person or via our live stream, we are glad you're here with us today. Just a few quick announcements before we get started. Connect Community Meals continues this week. Dinner will be from 5 to 6:30 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall. This Wednesday, the Connect Kids and Student Ministry programs begin. Connect Kids will meet at 6 p.m. with Connect Students beginning at 7. If you have any questions, see Wes Lowry for more information. Following the service this morning, we will have a second floor open house in the cafe. Join us to tour the new second floor improvements. Are there any other announcements?
Good morning, church. This Friday, our church is going to be hosting our fifth quarter, and we're going to be doing so at the bowling alley. If you are interested in contributing funds, hanging out with us during that time in the evening, or even contributing a snack, please let me know or let Jan know in the office. Thank you.
If we can be in prayer for you, please let us know via the church office. We'd love to be praying for you in any way that we can. At this time, let us prepare our hearts for worship.
Good morning. A good word this morning from Psalms, verse 100, verses 1 through 5, chapter 100, verses 1 through 5. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. We are so glad you are here this morning. And you know, this morning we are called to worship the Lord. We are called to make a joyful noise unto him and to serve him with gladness, for we are his creation. So this morning, we are thankful that we can be the recipients of God's steadfast love and grace. So as we enter into a time of worship together, we invite you to stand. We're going to acknowledge his presence with gratitude and acknowledge his eternal goodness and love for us. So please stand with us now as we enter into worship. Of course, we invite you to sing along with us.
The earth into motion, my soul now to stand. You stood before my failure and carried the cross for my shame. Sin weighed upon your shoulders. Soul now to stand. So what can I say? And what can I do? But offer this heart, oh God, completely to you. So what can I say? And what can I do? But offer this heart, oh God, completely to you. So I'll walk upon salvation, your spirit alive in me, life to declare your promise, my soul now to stand. So what can I say? and what can I do? But offer this heart, oh God, completely to you. Say, and what can I do? But offer this heart. I'll stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one who gave it all. And I'll stand by soul, Lord, to you surrendered all I am is yours. So I'll stand.
Father God, we are standing here in your presence with our hearts lifted high, with our hearts surrendered to you. We thank you that you are such an amazing God that we can't even begin to fathom all that you have done for us, the power that you have, that you spun the world and the universe into motion, that you put your life into us, and that you have set us on a path to union with you. You've made that path possible through the death of your Son, and you've invited us into this life with you, this life where you are working all around us, that you are restoring a broken creation. And God, I just thank you for this church family, for this opportunity to gather together this morning to lift our hearts and our voices in worship to you. God, I thank you for the Sterling College missions team that is here today, and the testimonies and the stories that will be told of the things that you've done through them and the things that they've learned about you through their service to you, God. God, we give you ourselves. We give you this service. We pray that you would speak to our hearts and that we would respond to you and what you're doing in this world and in our lives in a heart of abandonment and surrender and obedience to you. We love you, God, and we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship your holy name. It's time to sing your song again, whatever may pass and whatever lies before, let me be holy name.
This morning we have the privilege to have with us a mission team from Sterling College. And so Sterling College has a long and rich history of integrating faith into academics and student life and all parts of the college experience, as well as serving here in the community, on campus, and throughout the world. And so we are particularly glad to have the group here this morning, and we're pleased to be able to have partnered with you as part of your experience and mission work, and we're excited to hear about the wonderful things that God has done as part of that. So we can welcome them here this morning and invite the children to come down for the children's moment at this time.
Okay, we're gonna talk a little bit about like what a mission is. So do you guys know what a mission is? Yeah, does anyone have any other answers? That's a good one. Okay, so have you ever been on a mission? So have you guys ever helped anybody with anything? And can you give an example of what you've done? A mission trip, where'd you go? To the beach? What'd you do there? Yeah, that's awesome. That's like a perfect example of a mission trip. Other things that could be one is like you can help your parents look for their car keys or something like that. And so as Christians, we all have a mission.
Do you guys know what that mission is as Christians?
What is it?
Pretty good. What about you? That's a great one. To be disciples who make disciples, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So, does anyone know what exactly a disciple is?
Yeah.
Right, exactly. What about you? Good. It's pretty much just any follower of Jesus, so we're all disciples, right? What about you? Yeah, me too. So, yeah, same. So my mission and your mission is to help others learn about Jesus by being a student of the Bible and sharing what we know about being a Christian with others. How do we share that we're a Christian? Does anyone know? Yeah? That's good. That's a great one. Anyone else? Okay, so some really great things that we can do are just acting like Jesus. So caring about others, being kind, and telling people about Jesus are some really great ones, and just sharing his love. So yeah.
Okay, so if you guys will bow your heads and pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for today. Thank you for sending your son down to earth to save everybody. And yeah, just thank you. And thank you for the opportunity to come here and speak. I just pray that for missions, and that just thanks to this church who helped us go on this mission. And I just pray that when you ask us to go somewhere, we go for you. In your name I pray, amen.
Hey, let's give the kids a round of applause. They are cute, aren't they? I'm so glad my kids weren't here this morning. They would have said a wrong answer. They would have embarrassed me. But church, thank you so much for allowing us to be here this morning. What you'll hear this morning briefly is you were part of sending us to Oaxaca, Mexico this past May. And let me just tell you, God changed lives over there in Mexico, but I guarantee he also changed lives within our team. And let me just let you know, once you get the heartbeat for missions and joining his mission with our lives, we want to give everything to the Lord Jesus Christ. And as you heard, God is using Sterling College and also local surrounding churches and churches like you to send us. So you were part of this. You sent us. So we did this together. Now we want to show you a video of what we did collectively as his body.
We want our coffee in the lobby. We watch our worship on the screen. We got a rock star preacher who won't wake us from our dreams. We want our blessings in our pocket. We keep our missions overseas. For the hurting in our city, or would we even cross the street? But we want to see the heart set free and the tyrants kneel. The walls fall down and our land be healed. But church, if we want to see a change in the world out there, it's got to start right here. It's got to start right now. Lord, it's got to right here. Lord, it's got to right now. I'm like the brother of the prodigal, who turned his nose and puffed his chest. He didn't run off like his brother, but his soul was just as dead. What if the church on Sunday was still the church on Monday too? What if we came down from our towers and walked a mile in someone's shoes? 'Cause we want to see the heart set free and the tyrants kneel. The walls fall down and our land be healed. But church, if we want to see a change in the world out there, it's got to start right here. It's got to start right now. Lord, I'm starting right here. Lord, I'm starting right. People who are called by
will surrender all our pride and turn from our way. He will hear from heaven and forgive our sin. He will heal our land, but it starts right here. We're the people who are called by His name. If we'll surrender all our pride and turn from our ways, He will hear from heaven and forgive our sin. He will heal our land. It's gotta start right here. It's gotta start right now.
Good morning. First off, I just want to say thank you. We would not have been able to do this without you guys, so that's like the first thing I want to say is just thank you for your support. In the next few minutes, because I don't have very much time, there's kind of three things that I want you to just kind of get from this. So like if you don't get anything else from it, get these three things. So the first thing that I want you to just remember is there's a battle going on between good and evil, and whether you see it or whether you don't, it's there, and it's very, very real. And the second thing that I want you to remember is that the church is fighting that battle, and the church is succeeding, the church is growing, it's thriving. I have up here the Majority World Church because it's not just our churches here in our community. It does include those churches, but that's God's church around the world. That's our brothers and sisters in Christ that are fighting that battle every single day. And the third thing I want you to remember is the reason for that is because Jesus is King, and that is the number one reason. So just to kind of give you a little bit of background, so Roca Blanca was started about 30 years ago by some people who are actually from Larned. And so they went down there, and their entire mission, if you want to pull up the first slide, their entire mission is to plant churches and to spread the gospel and to bring people into their base that they teach them the word and they teach them how to go minister to others, and then they send those people out to plant churches. So this is a picture of all the churches they have planted in Mexico. There's over 80 there in the last 30 years. And this is in what they call their prayer hut. So their staff gets together every week, but people pray there every single day, but their staff gets together every week to pray, and they pray over every single one of these churches that they have planted. So that's kind of like their mission, and that was just something that really hit me, was just the fact that like they bring people in to send them back out. Like their goal is not to bring people in and keep them there. Their goal is to bring people in, train them up, and then send them out to go spread Jesus to the people who need it. So that's kind of the first one. If you want to go to the second slide. So this is a picture of kind of the fountain where the base was kind of like started around. So they do something called Fuente de Gracia, or Fountain of Grace. And so everything that they do, their mission, they start it with worship and prayer. That's what everything is based on. And they used to do all of their praying around this fountain. It was just where they would gather every morning and pray. Now they've moved it into their prayer hut that they've built, which was in the last slide. But they named Fuente de Gracia after this fountain. And so what they do is every Tuesday they have an event, and they have a Bible school there. And so by their third year of Bible school, their students get to partake in this. So Fuente de Gracia, there's been times hundreds of people have come to the mission base to be prayed over for physical needs, spiritual, mental healing, all, like, anything you can think of. People will come to the base and they will pray over them. And when they pray, this is just something that hit me and that has changed me and kind of convicted me to change my prayer life. When they pray, it's personal. It is not passive. It is very active. And when they are praying, like, they are praying for a purpose, and they are praying to a very real God who hears their prayers, because Jesus hears our prayers and he heals, and he answers those prayers. So that's kind of what Fuente de Gracia is about, is people come and they are prayed over and they receive healing. And so that's kind of where it was named after, this fountain. That's where the base was started around. So if you want to go to the next one. So like I said, they center everything around prayer and worship. So this is their worship building. So we got to actually be there on a really cool night. They have worship night every Monday night for the whole base, but we actually got to be there on a really cool night. So they send people out. So all of their Bible students had just been out for a month on mission to their churches that they have planted. So we actually got to be there the night that they came back and shared about it, which is like super cool. So this is their worship hut. And so I took a picture because the ceiling was really cool. And so they get together every single week, and they get together to worship God. And this was like, just worship is like one of my favorite things, because it doesn't matter what language you speak, what culture you're in, just getting to worship together with brothers and sisters in Christ, and we're all worshiping the same Jesus, is just like one of the most beautiful things to me. We're all making a joyful noise, no matter what that noise is, whether it's good or bad or in a different language. But as long as it's a joyful noise that's praising Jesus. So yeah, like I said, they start everything with prayer and worship. So their theory is, we're going to worship God because that's what he deserves, and he deserves that first. And then we're going to pray, and he's going to answer our prayers because he loves us and he cares about us. And this is a two-way relationship. So if you want to go to the next one. So the last thing is, this is their church that we got to go to church with them on Sunday morning. This was my favorite part of the whole trip, because I remember we were standing there, and it was me and Taya, and like next to me, and then somebody else, maybe Paige, and we were singing Raise a Hallelujah, which most of us know. And so we sing that in chapel, and so of course we know the words to it in English, but they're singing it in Spanish. And I just remember, like, sitting there, and we're singing in English, and they're singing in Spanish, and it's all at the same time. And it was just, like, the most beautiful thing to me, just getting to all worship together with brothers and sisters. And even though they may be in a different country, different language, different culture, we share that in common when we're all just people that are here trying to spread the gospel and just praise Jesus and love people just the same as anybody else. So that was by far my favorite part of the trip. So this is their church. Their service looks a lot like ours do. That was just really cool. Philippians 2 says every nation and every tongue will praise Jesus. And so that was just amazing to get to see that. So that's all I have for you. And now it's Zach's turn.
Morning. Go. There we go. I also just... I mean, what Kaylee said at the beginning, I just really want to thank you guys for helping make our trip possible and everything. Something I got out of the trip, along with just like a class that we took before we went on the trip, was just that, like, sometimes we as Americans can tend to, like, get a big head of ourselves whenever we go on missions trips and think that we're going to be, like, they're, you know, heroes. And that, like, you know, they need to, like, know, like, everything about, like, what we have to share and everything. And I think the best way to, like, go about, you know, these trips is, like, to have a heart of humility. And let me read a scripture real quick. All right, so this is in Philippians 3, 2 through 7. It says, "Watch out for those dogs, those evildoers, those mutilators of the flesh, for it is we who are the circumcised, we who serve God by the Spirit, we who boast in Christ Jesus, and who put no confidence in the flesh, though I myself have reasons for such confidence. If someone else thinks that they have reasons to put confidence in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, in regards to the law, a Pharisee. As for zeal, persecuting the church, as for righteousness, based on the law, faultless. But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. So I think just remembering that, like, it's Christ who works in us, and so we can't put any confidence in our own flesh, and we can't take credit for anything that, you know, the good works that we do. So, yeah, I mean, I've got like two slides, I guess, but kind of didn't. But that was just the guy in the background. Like just throughout the entire week, he was just, I think, like having a heart of humility and just really so in the just serving us and everything like that, and just making great meals and everything, and you know, obviously never complained and just gave us food and did a great job. And then on the next slide, there's So there's just an older guy there that, I mean, we're going to serve him, but then he just wanted to like pray over each of us and just like take each of us by the hand, and I think it was just like really cool, and he was just wanting to like bless each one of us, and so I think that was just really cool examples that we got to see there. But yeah, that's all I got.
Good morning. So today I titled my talk, Challenge to Serve, right? I love to serve, and once again, thank you to y'all, we were able to go and serve. And so here's a point that I'm kind of thinking about here, right? We should be challenged to serve, even though sometimes serving can be challenging, right? We should want to go out there and serve, even though it's hard. So on my first slide, we'll go ahead and dig right in. I have a lot, but I'll try to go quick. You see me with the shovel, right? Let me tell you, I'm from Texas. I'm from South Texas, and it gets a little hot there. But let me tell you, the heat does not compare to the heat in Mexico. And we're out here digging holes. It was pretty hard. I'm not going to lie. It was hot. But I was there to embrace the challenge, and we as a team were embracing the challenge because we knew that our uncomfortableness is way less than going out to serve. Like, it's way more important to serve than for us to be uncomfortable. The next slide is similar. It's me and Taya digging, right? So this hole is kind of funny because it's the same situation. Is we thought we were done. We're like, oh, it's good. We're finished with this project. We can move on. And then they're like, nah, it's not done. It needs to be bigger and deeper. And we embraced the challenge, and we made it correct because we were there for them and to serve them and to love them and to spread the gospel. And so we can go ahead and go to the next one. All right, this is the same guy as Zach had pictured, but he was a really awesome guy. He was really thankful. He prayed over us. And so we were just able to go out there and serve him. So this part was challenging because sometimes for me, it's hard to go up and meet new people, to talk to new people. But I remembered that it's not about me. It's about him. It's about Jesus. It's about making him known. It's about loving him and serving him, but loving others and serving others. And so we had the opportunity to do that and go to others and do that. And then the next slide is kind of similar, right? We were able to hang out with this youth group, with all these kids, and just play with them. And sometimes that's hard because we're like, I don't know you. Like, what? But we were able to build those relationships and just have fun with each other and love each other. And then we can go to the next one. All right, this is my last one, I think. But it's all these bricks, right? So I'm talking about challenge to serve. It's not always easy to serve, but God calls us to serve. And we know that obedience is what's necessary and what we're called to. And so I'm going to make up a number here. It might be an exaggeration, but it might be, you know, less than that. I'm going to say we moved 1,000 bricks. It might have only been 500, something like that. I don't know how much it was. But we moved a lot of bricks as a team. That doesn't sound really easy, but we're throwing them. We're, you know, getting up early doing it, trying to beat the heat. And just as a team, it was great to be able to be challenged together for his kingdom. And so my last point is that Jesus was challenged to serve. He knew that serving might not always be easy. He knew that he was going to be persecuted, such as him going up and healing lepers, right? Like going and healing the lepers, or such as him, you know, doing all the stuff he did. He got down, humbled himself before others, and washed the disciples' feet. Like, he was challenged to serve, and he's our example. And so Thanks to you, I was able to be challenged to serve. I was able to go out there and serve others, do something I love to glorify God. So thank you.
Hi, guys. How are you today? So I'm just going to be talking about a couple of things that I struggled with when deciding whether or not to go on this mission. The first of which was worthiness. I didn't really feel worthy to go out and serve in the name of the Lord. That's a really big thing. And there's like definitely better options of people who know more about the Bible or are further along in their walk with God. And I didn't really feel like I was one of the people that, you know, should be doing that. But I had a really good friend remind me that that's just the enemy speaking. The enemy doesn't want us to go out and share the love of the Lord to the rest of the world and show them how amazing he is. And so one of the verses that really helps me with this is Micah 6:8. It says, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God." Nowhere here or anywhere else in the Bible does it say that you have to be some expert on the Bible or some super Christian that never sins to go out and serve the Lord. And as you see in this here picture, the things that we didn't have to be an expert on the Bible, and we just worked for the people there and shared his love, because that's really all that Jesus wants us to do. We don't have to be anyone special, because some of the most basic types of serving is just sharing his love, which is so easy. So yeah, you don't have to be anyone special. Anyone can serve, and we're all called to serve. So yeah, and the other thing that I had a hard time with was the language barrier. I figured, how could I be successful and contribute anything if I couldn't even speak the language they were speaking? But that ended up not even being a problem. As you can see in the next slide, we played soccer with the kids, and they like taught us their names, and that was really all we needed to know. We would call their name and say, "Aki, Aki," and we would play soccer with the kids, and it was so amazing. Or we played with tops, and they would call out like the color that was gonna win, and it was so fun. We played duck, duck, goose in the next slide, and they taught us the names for duck and goose, and it was crazy to have fellowship with people that you couldn't even communicate with and see how Jesus was working in a place that's so far outside yourself, and be able to, you know, have community in these types of places. So yeah, neither of those things ended up being a problem, and it ended up working way more in my soul and the souls of my friends. And yeah, it was just a really amazing experience. And yeah, that's pretty much what I have for you.
Good morning. I'm Paige Rowland, and today I just wanted to talk to you about like the joy that I had in serving. But first of all, I just want to thank you guys for like helping fund this and for covering us in prayer, because that was really awesome. So on the first slide, there's a picture of kind of what just Morgan just showed about us playing duck, duck, goose with them. And that was just so much fun because, like, once again, like she said, there was just, like, I took French all 4 years in high school. So going to Mexico, I'm lost. I don't have any idea how to speak Spanish. And so just being able to, like, have fellowship and just be there, have fun, be new people, like, for that the kids can see and play with, that was pretty awesome. And then on the next slide, there's a picture of Taya and I with this ginormous rock. So a lot of the things we had to do was like manual labor, and it was like digging this trench. And so this rock, and maybe even a little bit of a bigger one, covered the entire width of the trench. And so like we're digging and we're like, this isn't even that big, this is fine. And then it just keeps going and keeps going across. And so like it was a tough job, but it was just so much fun because I've never had to dig a trench before, and just being able to like use random things like a pickaxe that I've never touched before. And just joking around with Taya and the team, and like being able to like defeat the rock, just having fun serving and like helping the people that they need there. And then the last slide that I have for you guys is us on top of the trade school that they were building. And for this slide, we were jumping off the bricks because we just had a lot of fun. And so with the bricks, like they said that they wouldn't move the bricks unless they like needed those specific bricks at that time. And so it was gonna like be so much worse if we hadn't moved that bricks. But it was just like a honestly pretty fun and easy job for us. Like we just joked around the whole time. We're laughing. Bowley is always ready to crack a joke and laugh, and that's just so awesome. And so just being able to like just sit there and toss and then just have fellowship with each other. Like, everything was so fun. And so, yeah, like, the thing I just want to say to you guys is that, like, if you ever have the opportunity to go on a mission trip, you should definitely do it, because even, like, the hard stuff is just a lot of fun, and it's just wonderful to be able to serve Jesus. And once again, thank you so much for all of the prayers and all of the support you gave us.
Hello. Again, I want to say thank you. This was an amazing opportunity for me to go with this group of students and Pastor Jose. And it was an opportunity to share God's love in ways that I haven't had the opportunity before, because it wasn't just with the people we were serving there, but it was also with the new friends that we made. If you go to the next slide. We had an opportunity to share God's love. We had an opportunity to pray with and over others, and they prayed for us. And it was at the beginning when there was a picture that Zach had with a young man that was serving us, and we were saying, well, we feel odd that we have these other people serving us. We came here to serve them. And we were told that we were a blessing to them, because if we weren't there, they didn't have a job. So we were a blessing to them. And as we were doing this hard work, and in Galatians 6:9, it says, do not grow weary of doing good, because in the end, you will be rewarded if you do not give up. Well, let me tell you, there were times that we thought, with the rock, with the ditches, with different things, that it would be easy to give up. But there would be people walking by us going to the trade school saying thank you. They didn't know who we were. We didn't know who they were, but they were thankful that we were there to serve them. And so the opportunity to share God's love was all around us. Next slide, please. We had what was called dispensa, and we filled bags with, there was food and other items in there, and we walked some roads to houses, I'll call them houses, dwellings, places where people lived, and we gave them the things that we had in the bag, and they were thankful, and we were blessed by them as well, by their words, by their smiles, by seeing the situation that they lived in, and how we could share our love with them with what we had, which really was just a bag of stuff, but they were very grateful for that. Next slide, please. And the opportunity to share God's love across cultures with other people, we met so many people that we will probably never, ever forget. I can't not hear the name Kevin. He was the little boy that was eating the bubbles, and when we were playing games, you had to be there. You had to be there, but we were yelling his name because we were playing a game, and he was had so much energy, and we were tired. We had worked all day, and then we were going to play games with these kids, and I know these guys are younger, but it was an awesome opportunity, and I thank you for the support that you gave to the whole mission team, because you were part of sharing that love, because you helped us to go. Thank you.
All right, hi, I'm Taya. Everybody else has gotten to practice this once before in chapel, so this is like my first time actually talking about this, so it might go really bad, and I'm really sorry about that. But the verse that keeps coming to my mind is Isaiah 6:8, and the Lord is speaking to Isaiah, and he says, who shall go for us? Who shall I send? And Isaiah says, here I am, send me. And that's just kind of the idea behind missions. It's like, you don't have to be worthy. You don't have to be qualified. You just have to be, here I am, send me. And sometimes like that just really like weighs on me, because I'm like, how often am I willing to be like, hey God, I guess I'm here. I guess you can use me if you want. And I don't actually mean it. And I found that like, yeah, when you actually say yes and you're like, send me, I'm here, God provides. He doesn't call the qualified, he qualifies the called, is the cliche saying there. And so the whole idea, like, funding, I'm like, I'm going to be a broke teacher the rest of my life. Where am I going to get this money from? And he sends your church to give us the funding and traveling. And there are all these things. I don't know Spanish. I don't know all these different things. And God provides translators so you understand what people are saying. And he provides just these people that you meet and all these experiences that you get to take back with you. And all of those things were really, like, just life-changing. But then you come back and it's like, oh, okay, like, I'm back. I'm done with my mission. I don't have to be here anymore. And I think that's where God really started to challenge me, is he's like, no, I'm not done. Like, you said, here I am, send me. And I didn't mean Mexico. I meant, you're here, go. And so I've got to learn in teaching in Wiley Elementary that it's like, yeah, here you are, Taya. Go love those kids for me. And I just want to challenge y'all. It's not about going overseas or to Mexico or to Africa. You're here. Here you are. Send you to your families to love them and to grow them into the godly men and women that God wants to love, that he's there for. Go into your job and love your coworkers that are really hard to get along with and show them God's love. Go into the community of Sterling, because as little as we are, I guarantee there are still people out there who need God's love. Go. Quit saying somebody else has got it. Somebody else is more qualified. Somebody else could do this instead, and they'll probably do it better. Because right now God is saying, I need you right here to be willing to stand there and be, here I am, Lord. Send me wherever you're going to call. If that's here in Sterling, Kansas. If that's here in America, because Lord knows the church needs help here. Or if that's over in Mexico or wherever else he's going to call you to. You stand there and you say, here I am, Lord, you send me. And then I have pictures, but that really has nothing to do with what I just said, but it's really fun. Because when you go, when you're open to that, you're going to have experiences and you're going to get to meet people. I didn't really know Paige that well before we went on this missions trip, and she's absolutely changed my life. And I've loved getting to learn about where she's going to go and how she's going to love kids. And the same with Morgan. And I mean, me and Kaylee are related, so that's, and with Jason and Debbie and Jose, like, the people around you that are gonna build you up and gonna help you go where the Lord sends you are so important. So I thank y'all so much for being that provision that we needed to go. And now I challenge you, you're next. Wherever you are in life, you are next. Here you are, send you.
So, church, you've heard it, these testimonies, how you helped send us to Mexico. On behalf of Sterling College, we want to thank you. We want to continue this relationship and this partnership for a long time. Sterling College will continue going. We'll be going to Cusco, Peru this Christmas. We'll be going to West Ghana, Africa next May in 2024 in Cordova, Alaska. So if you want to hear more about our missions, I'd love to talk to you. But once again, thank you on behalf of Sterling College.
Somebody asked me the other day, so what are you going to do? I don't know. Here I am. And is that not one of the best sermons you heard? Huh? Come on, guys. You know, I heard and I saw, first I saw a lot of digging. And in that digging, I saw foundations being laid, because obviously you were digging for foundations, right? And so that you could build with the bricks and keep building upon that. And I heard words like blessed to serve, but to be served by them. Called to trust, going. You know, I hear all these words. So as we have this opportunity, we're going to pray for each one of you. Just because you shared with us. I've been to Mexico before, and I understand the depth of that. And I still have just a few seconds, because you guys are right on time. They told me if they're not done by 10 till 10, you know, we're not going to get done in time. And then I have another church to go to, so I'll just have to leave, but I don't get to. I have to ask a question. Were you depressed when you got back with all that you have? Yeah. It takes a while. It takes a while to know what you have and others don't, but they have so much more to offer you. So what we can do is with that, and that blessing, you know, I'm touched because I have memories of my mission trip. I have memories of my daughters going on mission trips and changing their lives together. So let's be in prayer. Heavenly and gracious Father, I lift Pastor Jose and Kaylee and Zach, Jason, Morgan, Paige, Debbie, and Taya, who were made available, who said, here I am. Not knowing where they were going for sure, I mean to a place, but not where you were going to send them. Into the depths of their faith, understanding the importance of what it means to be a disciple. Father, I just bless each one of them here today. I pray over their hearts and that the missions that the Sterling College is looking forward to, that the Sterling First United Methodist Church is also able to help support through offerings and gifts. We offer all these things in your name. Amen. You know, we still have in our own community trials and tribulations, and if there is a moment that somebody's just heavy on their heart, something that needs to lift up. Is there anybody that needs to lift anything in particular this morning? The disciples, like you, like us, were watching Jesus, and they wanted to know how to be connected to the Father. And they wanted that prayer life. And he said, well, if you don't know, watch this. Pray like this. Would you join with me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. And now we will have our offering time, where we usually go.
Okay. Thank you, Pastor Rob. As we continue in worship this morning, we respond to God's word and his call for our lives. One of the ways in which we can do that is our offering. So as we invite the ushers to come forward, we see firsthand now how our offering can be used to serve. Thank you for joining us today, team from the Sterling College. That was wonderful. But again, it's a shining example of what we can do right here in Sterling. So as we collect our offering today and we continue in worship, let's just think about this is our commitment to give back to God a portion of which he has blessed us with so much today. So let us respond to his call here today with our offering and song.
We bow our hearts, we bend our knees. O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. O Lord, we cast down our idols.
One more time. We bow our hearts.
We bow our hearts. We bend our knees. O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. O Lord, we cast down our idols. So give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob.
We bow our hearts.
We bow our hearts. We bend our knees. O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. O Lord, we cast down our idols. So give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob.
Bring our offerings forward. Would you please stand as we sing our doxology?
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and
yes, so stay standing and sing together our closing song, Here I Am, Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who make the stars of night,
I will make the darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me, and I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? And I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me, and I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them, my hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them, whom shall I send? And here I am, Lord, and is it I, Lord? And I have heard you calling in the night. And I will go, Lord, and if you lead me, and I will hold your people in my heart.
Benediction is a blessing, so receive this blessing now. The same one that Jesus gave. In Matthew 28, he said, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded. And remember, I am with you always to the end of age. Amen."